بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم صل على محمد. Yes, I can. A program that reviews one of our religion's most important values, positivity in life. And when it comes to inspiration, positivity in life, optimism in life, nothing is like the Quran in terms of inspiration, in terms of motivation, and then the Sunnah of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear viewers, a man came to the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a Bedouin man, came and he asked him a very important question, a question that we need to know the answer of all of us. He said, Messenger of Allah, who is the most beloved person to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And what are the most beloved actions in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The Nabi, when he got the questions, he paused for a while. And all the companions were with him. They were all waiting with the answer. Then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most beloved person to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most beneficial to others. And the most beloved deed in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to make a Muslim happy, to bring the happiness in the heart of the Muslim, or to remove his troubles, or to relieve him from his troubles, his calamities, his difficulties, his hardship, or to pay off his debt, or to feed him if he's hungry. And then he said, and for me to walk with my brother for his need until I fulfill his need, it is better for me than secluding myself in this masjid for a month. Subhanallah. And then he said, and whoever suppresses or swallows his anger, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will conceal his faults. And whoever controls his rage, even though he's able to take retaliation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will fill his heart with security on the day of judgment. And whoever walks with his brother regarding a need until he secures his need, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, will keep firm his foot when every foot is shaken. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us firm foot on that day. Dear viewers, this is how the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam directed us to understand that the more positive we are in this life, the more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we will be. Astonishing advice, incredible advice. It tells us what we should prioritize in our lives. If we really want to gain the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty. Dear viewers, you might ask, is it to this degree that Allah Ta'ala loves bringing the joy to the heart of our Muslim brother? Yes. And that's why those who are firmly rooted in knowledge were well aware of this. When Imam Malik rahimahullah ta'ala was asked, which deed do you like the most? He replied, bringing joy to the Muslims. Subhanallah. Dear viewers, one of the great values of this religion is that the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is made revolving around actions in which benefit is wider, in which the benefit is wider. And this is to create a cohesive, loving, and merciful society. Merciful society in which each individual seek to make others happy and bring joy and pleasure in their hearts, in their lives. And that's why one of the most beloved deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was a pleasure that you bring in the heart of a Muslim. Dear viewers, let's mention some practical example of bringing happiness to the hearts of a Muslim. First of all, tolerance and gentleness in dealing with people. Tolerance and gentleness beautify everything around you. It will bring happiness in the hearts of people. And that's why the Nabi ﷺ said, whenever gentleness is in something, it will beautify it. And whenever gentleness is removed from something, it will turn it ugly. And amongst the ways of bringing happiness to others, the smile. The smile on their faces. It is the sunnah of the Nabi ﷺ and the guidance of the first teacher and the first inspirer sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Also among the ways of bringing happiness to others, the gift. It causes love. It establishes affection. It removes grudges. and it reconciles hearts. And that's why the Nabi said, تهادوا تحابوا. Give gifts and you will love one another. Also among the ways of bringing joy and happiness to others is spreading salam. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, you will never enter Jannah until you believe, and you will never believe until you love each other. May I inform you of something, if you do it, you will love each other. Promote greeting, salam amongst you by saying assalamu alaykum profusely a lot. Subhanallah. What a lovely commandment. What a lovely advice. Spreading peace, spreading love. And is there a definition for positivity other than that? Subhanallah. But whom we should greet? Our friends? Our families? No. A man came to the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he asked him, which Islam is better? He said, تُطْعِمُ الطَّعَامِ وَتَقْرَأُ السَّلَامَ عَلَى مَنْ عَرَفْتَ وَمَنْ لَمْ تَعْرِفْتَ. You feed the needy and you greet those whom you know and those whom you don't know. Subhanallah. Through these kinds of practices, we can spread love. We can spread harmony. We can spread respect. We can spread tranquility and create an amazing society. Dear viewers, yes we can. Yes we can bring happiness to those around us. Yes we can bring joy into the hearts of the poor. Yes we can feed the needy people. Yes we can spread peace. Yes we can meet people with a smile. Yes we can surprise those we love with gifts. Yes we can create an amazing society. Till I see you again in the next episode of Yes I Can, I ask Allah Ta'ala to preserve you and to bless you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.